milestone that I achieved in 2021 was being on the cover of Women Entrepreneur Business Magazine, where I was voted one of the top 10 female corporate coaches in India. नमस्ते, मैं हूं एवरिल क्यू और ये मेरी कहानी है। आई वॉज इन शो बिजनेस फॉर 22 इयर्स एंड व्हाइल आई वॉज इन शो बिजनेस आई वॉज नॉट हैप्पी विद माई सेल्फ। आई यूज टू ऑलवेज कंपेयर माई सेल्फ टू अदर पीपल। माई मैनेजर्स वर वेरी रूड टू मी। एवरीबडी वॉज इनसिक्योर, आई वॉज इनसिक्योर। और वहां पे दोस्त की कोई चीज नहीं होती है, बिकॉज यू डोंट नो हु इज गोइंग टू स्टैब यू इन द बैक। मैं बहुत इनसिक्योर थी और मैं हर वक्त सोचती थी कि व्हेन इज इट गोइंग टू बी माय डाउनफॉल, व्हेन एम आई नॉट गोइंग टू गेट वर्क, विल दिस बी माय लास्ट जॉब। ताजुब की बात तो ये है दैट आई हैव परफॉर्म्ड विद द बेस्ट आर्टिस्ट इन इंडिया। आई हैव कोलैबोरेटेड विद द बेस्ट, फ्रॉम एआर रहमान टू अनिल कपूर। आई हैव संग ऑन स्टेज, आई हैव डन मोर देन 3000 शोज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। लेकिन दिल में कुछ नहीं था। आई वॉज एम्प्टी, खुशी नहीं थी। गुड फ्रेंड्स वर नॉट देयर। व्हेन माय फादर फेल इल एंड ही वाज टोल्ड ही हैड ओनली 6 months टू लिव, नोबडी स्टूड फॉर मी। ऑल दी सो कॉल्ड फ्रेंड्स इन शो बिजनेस सब भाग गए। उनको डर लग रहा था कि शायद आई विल पैसे ना पूछे। और बस I started studying energy, energy therapy and the mind at that time. Cut to, today I'm here. This is my company Avril's Cues, where I help people to really bring about change in their lives. So I'm here to talk to you about Avril's Cues, my company, and I am the founder of the company Avril's Cues. What made you start Avril's Cues? So the reason I started Avril's Cues is because I was very unhappy in show business. I was not getting really good opportunities because of, you know, I was not able to perform favors for people. I never used to want to go for parties because at this time I had already begun studying about the mind. My father died. I started studying Buddhist psychology and I was already studying about the mind. So all these, you know, going out, drinking, smoking, all this was not my scene. I never enjoyed it anyway. So I began to stay away from all these so-called networking parties. By the way, वहाँ पे कुछ networking ही नहीं होती है। सारे लोग वहाँ पे मतलब बदतमीजी करते हैं, but everybody says networking parties, ठीक है? Anyway, so my mother at that time in 2017, she had to undergo a surgery. Aur wo time pe I was studying with a famous law of attraction coach called Mr. Bob Proctor. Shayad aapne unhe The Secret, the movie The Secret mein dekha hoga. So I was mentoring with him for a year. And he said that the only thing stopping you is fear and your mental mindset. So challenge yourself. Waise bhi aapko showbiz mein abhi कुछ अच्छा ही नहीं लगता है, तो यू क्लोज द कंपनी, वापस बैंगलोर जाओ, दैट्स एंड योर मदर ऑल्सो नीड्स यू, और आप अपनी कंपनी शुरू करो, स्टार्ट हेल्पिंग पीपल, बिकॉज दैट्स वॉट यू से यू वॉन्ट टू डू। एंड आई टुक अ लीप ऑफ फेथ, आई सोल्ड ऑल माई स्टफ, माई मूव्ड आउट ऑफ माई अपार्टमेंट, केम टू बैंगलोर एंड आई स्टार्टेड Avril's Cues इन 2017 टू हेल्प पीपल अंडरस्टैंड दैट द पावर लाइज विद इन देम एंड दैट देयर मेंटल हेल्थ is one of the most important things that they can take care of and nobody else can do it for you except yourself. Your husband, your wife, your children, nobody can help you. Only you can help yourself. I also started Avril's Cues to teach a philosophy of life, mind, body, heart and soul. This is a continuum, it's a construct. If one area of these four areas is not aligned, if you're not happy in it, it will have a negative impact on all the other areas of your life. So this is the reason I started Avril's Cues, to empower people. So I got introduced to mental wellness through my own mental wellness journey. I was already studying Buddhist psychology. I was already a certified, trained pranic healer. I was doing EFT, emotional freedom technique. I had already trained as a counselor. And so I was already an energy architect. An energy architect means you work with people's energies to align them on the mind, body, heart, soul connect. So I was already studying the mind. In Sanskrit, mindfulness is known as vritti. So I had an understanding of that, and then I went on to become a certified mindful instructor with the Awakened Mind in Australia. So my mental wellness journey started when I was in show business, because I was always either severely depressed or mildly depressed. Aur bahut sharam ki baat thi, because everybody, if you told them ki bhai I'm feeling like this, they would stigmatize you. They would think that what's wrong with her? Matlab problem kya hai? Maybe she needs to go and see a mental doctor. Lot of misconceptions about mental wellness. Mental wellness is simply being emotionally, psychologically, and mentally in the right place. It's not the same as being mentally challenged, like having autism or actually having bipolar disorder or some other schizophrenia or multiple personality disorder. And so my journey started there. And that's why I opened Avril's Cues, because I was struggling. I didn't have anybody to go to. Nobody took me to a counselor. I couldn't find a counselor. I couldn't find the right person to help me. And so I thought, why are people struggling so much? There should be somebody to help them. And that's why I began helping people. What about your initial struggles when you first opened Avril's Cues? So the initial struggles when I first opened Avril's Cues were the same as any other entrepreneur faces. Nobody believed in me. Nobody supported me financially. I had to do everything on my own. I literally had to, you know, use myself as a guinea pig and use one or two of my friends who trusted me as guinea pigs to test out my different programs, to test out my different methods. I have a method that is called the Kundalini Plus method, where we combine certain Kriya yogas with meditation, with visualizations. Then we also have cognitive, matlab action plans, how to actually take your life forward by performing certain actions. And then we have chakra sadhana and nadi sadhana. This is energy therapy to clean out, to clear out your nadis and your chakras. So the initial work was that nobody believed in me. So I had to basically believe in myself and, you know, put my own money into my company, put my money where my mouth is and make it a success. And that's what I've done.
What was the first milestone that you can remember and you still cherish?
So the first milestone would be for me, after I met His Holiness the Dalai Lama. He's one of my personal gurus and he inspired me to do what I do, because we were talking one day in one of the teachings and he was saying something to the entire audience. There was an audience of around 40 to 50,000 people, and in that audience he said, the world needs healers and the world needs people to help other people. And in that moment, I understood that my life meant more than just entertaining people on stage. It meant to be of service to people, to have more purpose and meaning in my life. And actually that was one of the things that really helped me get through a lot of the initial struggles. When you asked me the previous question about my initial struggles and how difficult it was for me, I always remember this wisdom in these words that His Holiness said, that the world needs people to help other people and needs healers. The first milestone would be getting his blessing and meeting him in person. And I went on to meet him a couple of times after that in person, but that was the first milestone, getting his blessings and understanding that my life means much more than just singing and entertaining people.
Had you not started Avril's Cues, what other business would you have done?
If I had not started Avril's Cues, I would have definitely wanted to work with women and children. Because I think women epitomize excellence for me. Women epitomize full potential. Women can do anything they set their minds to, and we have the bandwidth to do it all. We are nurturers and we give birth and we nurture life. So women, if you can train a woman, if you can educate a girl, then you're setting up an entire community. And this has been said before, so it's not rocket science, but I firmly believe in this. And children are the most resilient, intelligent, sensitive, and emotionally aware human beings. They are like very, very intelligent beings, but in small bodies. They're far more intelligent than us. So I would definitely want to work specifically with women and children. And I'm so happy to say that I work a lot with women and children, especially with my program Shakti for Women and working one-on-one with little children.
What is the best thing you like about your work and why?
The best thing I like about my work is that it doesn't feel like work. I enjoy what I do. I work very hard. I'm very earnest. And I'm very proud of myself for that, because I think it's very important to have a good work ethic, to set an example for your clients. And I don't see it as work, because when I help my clients, whether they're corporates or individuals, I'm not just helping them, I'm primarily also helping myself, because I grow as a person. Every client teaches me something, every corporate teaches me something. And so it's like, you're learning, you're growing, you're teaching, you're making a living, and you're changing people's lives. So I'm very blessed.
What is the USP of Avril's Cues?
Wow. The USP of Avril's Cues is I customize programs for each and every client of mine, whether it's a corporate, whether it's a woman, whether it's a man, whether it's a child working in the B2B, B2C space. I never walk into a room till I don't know my audience intimately. I never take up sessions with a client till I don't consult with them and understand what is that specific thing, or what are those specific things that this person is looking for, because each of us is as unique as a thumbprint. So even though we may be women or men or children or a corporate or individuals, each corporate is different, each person is different. There is no other person like you on the planet. And keeping that in mind, I have taken it upon myself to curate and to specifically customize programs for each of my private therapy clients, my yoga students, and my corporate. So that's the USP. I customize and I value each person, each corporate as a client. Another milestone that I achieved in 2021 was being on the cover of Women Entrepreneur Business magazine, where I was voted one of the top 10 female corporate coaches in India. And I was featured in their cover story, and you can read all about my story there. And the other thing that I'm very proud of is that I got through my mental blocks and I made friends with fear to write my first book, You Should Be Scared: How 7 Key Fears Can Set You Free. It's trending on Amazon. It's available Kindle format and on Flipkart. And this has 5 stories of very brave people who have been my private therapy clients, explaining how they went from fear to freedom. It's also got 2 of my biggest fears and how I overcame them by making friends with fear and now living a life of fulfillment. I do hope that you will give some of my programs a try. I have so much free content on my website, on my social media platforms. I do weekly wraps every weekend on Instagram. I have a podcast coming out soon. I have so many webinars, at least twice a month. I have webinars which are very, very nominally priced, less than a meal on Zomato or Swiggy, and packed with content. I'm offering my book on discount at the moment on Amazon till the end of the year 2021. And I wish you a life full of happiness, success, joy, peace, and love. Live it with compassion. And I wish that you take mental wellness and your mental well-being very seriously, because no one else is going to help you there. I'm Avril Q, and like I always say, stay true to being you, because you matter. From my heart to yours, Atma Namaste.